Deontay Wilder versus Tyson Fury at the Staples Center for the WBC heavyweight title coming up Saturday, Showtime pay-per-view. Wilder is 40-0-0, 39 knockouts, and he has fought four times since 2017. All right, so Ted, what can you tell me about the big punching power of that young man from Tuscaloosa, Alabama, Deontay Wilder, the WBC champion?
Just raw power, big, strong, and these guys are for their size, they're cat quick. Like we talked about last weekend, it seems like there's been a genetic evolution of heavyweight boxers where they're getting taller, bigger, and believe it or not, faster. So I think, certainly he's got the power to walk away with the championship, but it's going to be a great fight.
All right, before we take a break and come back and talk about Tyson Fury, the former champion who also has a big punch, defeated Vladimir Klitschko, shedded all that weight, and a lot of people are saying he's the better boxer. I have to talk a little bit more about Deontay Wilder. There have been times where he has been out on his feet to where he's been able to get back on his feet and get a win. I don't think he's going to be able to make a mistake like that against a Tyson Fury because of Fury's ability to throw punches in combination. So what does Wilder have to do as opposed to trying to land that big punch to get a knockout early? Should he try to pace himself and get into some sort of rhythm as opposed to going straight for the knockout, Ted?
Like when you and I were calling a lot of fights, he's got to get past the fourth round. A lot of people will say the third round, but I think if he can get past the fourth round, his boxing skills and his ability to have weathered the storm, if you will, had gotten punched, been able to get up, I think if he can get through four rounds, he's got to be the favorite.
We'll come back. Tyson Fury next. One more video tonight from Legacy Studios in East Liverpool with Jimmy Joe Savage and Ted Arnault. Stay with us.